before we get started, this is my little makeup setup and a random pencil. But I'm gonna have these products listed down below, but this is what I'm using because I'm gonna be talking and it's a girl trap video. I will not be like holding it up and showing it to you guys. So I just wanted to give you this little tidbit. Good morning, happy Mother's Day. Today's Mother's Day. It's Sunday. I'm getting ready for church and I don't know, I just wanted to chat while I do my makeup. And I don't do my makeup as nearly as often as I used to with working from home. So, you know, what you gonna do? So, I leave the house maybe 2 days a week, which is Saturday to shop, which I'll do like a little something, and then Sunday to go to church. So, yeah, that's where we are. So, how have you guys been? I feel like it's been... I do my girl chats like quarterly in a way. So, it always feels like it's been a while. But, yeah, so I've been good, guys, and I just wanted to sit down and want to chat because I always have something to talk about, you know. So let's get started. But I don't know, like, crime has been kind of crazy. Like, I don't live in a big city. I live in a kind of small city, I would think, compared to other cities, but I don't feel like it's big. Am I gonna use just brushes today? I think so, because I don't have time for anything else. But yeah, so like, crime has been insane. Like, I'm scared. Like, it's crazy. Like, you can't even go to the mall. You can't go to the mall. You can't go to the fair. You can't go anywhere. There's always some crime. So like, at this point in my life, and if you can hear the children, I am so sorry, but they're in the tub. They're so loud, like mothering, you know? But, you hear that? It's crazy. It's crazy around here. But anyways, so like at this point, me and Alex are kind of just like, I want a house on a plot of land with a chicken coop and a vegetable garden. Like, I'm not in the city, so like, I'm kind of being dramatic. I am. I'm like on the outskirts, but still, I want to put me and some distance between me and some people because like, people are crazy. But yeah, I kind of want to be further on the outskirts. I want to be in the boonies, in the country, with a piece of land, some chickens, a vegetable garden, you know what I'm saying? A dog that can likes to run. Maybe not, because I can't have those dogs. I'm allergic to dogs, so I would have to have one of those dogs with hair. But you know what I mean. So I don't know, I don't want to be far from my church though, or from a Publix. Like, that is a please no. I need Publix in my life. I'm gonna go to church regardless, but you know what I mean. Publix, I can't give up Publix for like a Kroger. Like, I can't. I don't understand. Like, I can't do that. But anywho, yeah, like, the simple life, the farm life is calling to me and I want to answer. But like, right now I live like not in the suburbs, like kind of like on the outskirts. On the outskirts, like, but I wouldn't say like the absolute suburbs. I still have stuff to eat and all that. Like, it's not totally, it's not much, but it's not that, you know what I'm saying? So we are gonna do the vegetable garden here in the backyard because we have the space and we have like the perfect planter box. But I don't know, I just want my farm life dreams, especially all these kids I'm having. Like, we might as well be Little House on the Prairie at this point, you know. Speaking of church and not being far from church, like, in the crime, like, the spiritual warfare, like, y'all, it's real. Like, it is some spiritual warfare going on, which is why I think we have all these heinous crimes, all these disgusting crimes. Like, it's just evil on the earth, you know. Sin is rampant and it's just scary. So I think it's important to have church home, a church tribe. Like, yeah, I love my church tribe. My mom was like, you be introducing me to like 40, 50. I'm only 28. Like, I'd be introducing my mom to, like, or people. I'd be like, this is my friend. This is my friend. They'd be like 60-year-old women. But, like, those are my friends. Like, I don't know how to explain it. Like, when you have a bond with them, they become your friends. Like, even if they are old enough to be your mom, grandma, your grandma's grandma, like, that's my friend. We pray together. We talk about stuff. We understand each other. That's my tribe. So, yes, church is, like, the only place where, I'm like, work and church is, like, the only place where you have, like, these older people that you're around all the time. But, like, at church, you choose to be around them. At work, it's just kind of, like, they're there. But, like, all those people end up being, like, my work moms. Like, I wouldn't say, like, oh, this is my friend, you know, such and such from work who's older. I'll just be like, oh, yeah, this is my such and such. But, like, at church, I'll be like, this is my friend. I'm going to be like, I'm like, I'm for real, that's my friend. But, yeah, that's funny. But, yeah, y'all, get involved at the church. Get you some like-minded people so that when you encounter the people who aren't like-minded like you, that you know how to handle it. It's very important. Or that you, like, filled up enough to handle it, you know? And you got people praying for you and on your side, and it's just really good, especially small group. I love small groups, y'all. Like, that's my jam. Like, I do a small group every semester. I'm gonna lead one eventually, but right now I'm just an attendee because I'm pregnant, and, like, who knows what if I'm gonna come, or I always end up coming to all of them, but you know what I mean. Like, I just can't be responsible right now. I just can't. But yeah, so yeah, get involved in the church. There's a lot going on in the world. You need some extra prayer warriors, I tell you. We are back. Just had to do my brows. I know they probably look the same because I don't really do much to my brows anymore because this is what they're gonna be. But anywho, yeah. But also, before I move on from the church thing, get this Pray First book. It's free, it's downloadable. You can print it out if you got a job where there's a printer, print it out. And it's a prayer guide, and I get it. I know a lot of us probably think, like, hey, I'm a pretty mature Christian, I know how to pray. No. This is deeper than that. This is, like, some really good stuff. We have the table of contents and all this, but it has, like, different prayers. So creating a lifestyle of prayer teaches you pretty much how to pray, but it gives you some really good prayers, like worship his name. Like, I don't know. I went through and, like, I went and wrote, like, all the Hebraic names for God and Jesus so that I could have, because, like, my small group leader was saying that is a deeper form of worship by knowing his different names, like, you know, so it's just so good. Pray his agenda, depend on him from everything, forgive and be forgiven, engage in spiritual warfare. Like, y'all, I just literally had to pray, like, three of these yesterday because me and Alex, thank God, we're in a place in our walk where we can recognize the enemy, we can recognize the lies, and we can stop it before it gets to be so bad, before we even realize what's going on. Because back in the day, before we were mature in our walk, you just be confused. You know, you'd be like, why is this happening? Da, 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 da. Like, this is crazy. But, like, now we're able to point out. We know when we're under attack, and we know when we need to pray. And we have such a good relationship that we can talk about it. Like, I just love that man. But yeah, I really highly recommend that free prayer guide, and it's put on by Church of the Highlands by Chris Hodges. He's a really good pastor. I've watched him a few times. So get prayed up is what I'm saying. So, you guys, I've been watching some television because Alex has been on nights, so, like, we're not watching, like, anime together. He's off of it now, but, you know, I've just had, like, this free time to watch some things, see what some things are about. And, like, I fell into the trap and I started watching those doggone Kardashians. Like, I haven't watched them in forever, maybe in, like, a year. I haven't watched them in forever, but they have their little spinoff or their new show with Hulu, and it's just like, it's my cousin's fault. Shay, it's your fault. Like, she was like, hey, this is pretty good. I was like, what? She said, it looks like The Hills, and we love The Hills. And she's right. It does have, like, they did do a rebrand because the shooting, it doesn't look, it looks way better. It looks way better. Like, really good content. So, yeah, I've been watching that. I don't know. I feel like in the beginning, she was kind of leading Kanye on. Had him chasing down her adult tape, like calling him crying, like he's still her husband when she's trying to divorce the man. Like, that was really confusing. So I could see how he would be like, maybe I have a chance. So that was strange. I don't know why. She's like, I'm putting up boundaries, but like, are you putting up boundaries like to get back together, or are you putting back boundaries to like not ever get back together? Because it kind of seemed like she was kind of putting up boundaries to get back together. So that was strange to watch. And of course he took it the wrong way and was trying to, he got mad. It was just a whole thing. So I've been watching that mess. Not proud of myself. Not proud to say. But I've also been watching other trash television, like The Ultimatum. Y'all, The Ultimatum was crazy. Like, these kids be doing anything these days. And I'm saying that like I'm old, but like I really do feel old, because what the heck? Like, that was crazy. It was crazy. But in my opinion, Jake and Ray, they were the villains. And I had no idea. I wanted to like them, but they were the villains. Like, it was bad. It was giving not loyal. It was giving like first escape, I'm running, that's it. But another person I did not care for, even though he didn't do anything, he was kind of really sweet, was Randall. But he was just so feminine, and like he was attracting the masculine in women, and it was just kind of strange to see that dynamic play out. He was putting women in their masculine because he was so feminine. Like, he's getting the same like character in each woman that he meets or that he's attracting. So it's just like, Shanique, she would kind of take the lead role. And then when Madeline got with him, she had to kind of take the lead role, and he was just kind of compliant and feminine energy. It was strange. I don't like it, but To each his own. I don't want to be in my masculine constantly. And I just feel like a woman with a Randall type will never find rest, because she is the masculine energy. And it's just like, no, sir. No, thank you. But hey, to each his own. But anywho, and then just a quick rundown of everybody else. Zay, he was childish. He was childish. But Ray did him wrong, but he was childish. Kobe was trying to humble Madeline. He was trying to humble Madeline, and Madeline was trying to get revenge on Kobe for trying to humble her, because that was a crazy dynamic. She couldn't stand that man, and then she got married and had his baby. But I mean, I guess it'd be like that. Shanique, she was childish and bratty, in my opinion. Like, just to boil it down, she had some valid points, and you know, she wasn't her masculine with Randall. But I feel like even with Zay, he challenged her. And I can see where there's an attraction in that, because like, she don't get challenged. So whatever. And then April, girl, I'm glad she ran, because she needed to. She needed to run away as fast as she could, because they was tripping. Like, Jake and that girl Ray was tripping. Like, that was insane. So I've been watching that. And then like yesterday, y'all, I watched Enemy of the State with Will Smith in it. Why was that movie so good this time as an adult? I used to watch it all the time as a kid. But now with this adult lens, he made some bad decisions, but I love that movie. It's a random movie from like 1998, like seriously. But had Regina King, you know, we had good representation, black lawyer, his black lawyer wife, nice house. I mean, he became Enemy of the State, but it was just good. It was so refreshing to see. So refreshing. And we did watch older movies to remember. As you guys may know or may not know, but you should know, definitely should know, I am 15 weeks pregnant. So that's a thing that's happening. I'm growing a baby right now. But I want to talk to you guys about my journey a little bit. It's been really good. Like, really good. I don't know if I just don't remember things from when I was pregnant with the girls, or if I just wasn't cognizant of my body then as much as I am now, since I'm older and I'm a little more mature and I'm paying attention more. But like, everything's so, I'm feeling pressure, like a lot of pressure. I don't remember feeling pressure. And I had two babies in my belly the last time. So I don't know, I'm feeling a lot of pressure. Everything's like rapid. Like, I had a belly bump. And no one a fat, like it wasn't my fat, like it was the difference. Like, even Alex was like, whoa. But I had a bump at 2 months. I was 2 months pregnant with a belly bump. Like, noticeable. It's crazy. But yeah, my doctor said everything happens faster, including the round ligament pains and my uterus being stretched back out, because apparently when they stretch, they contract even tighter, and then they stretch it again and now it hurts. So I'm having round ligament pains right now, like shooting up from the bottom of my belly, like my uterus, to the top. Y'all, that's just crazy. And I'm experiencing a lot of itching when it comes to my belly stretching. It's stretching right now. And like, I moisturize twice a day and I'm still having some itching. So I don't know what's up with that. But other than that, it's been really good. It's been very enjoyable. I can feel kicks now. I think I wanna go like this, and then maybe, ooh, that's pretty. Maybe do a little pink on top. But yeah, I can feel kicks right now. Not like hard kicks, it's more like flutters or like rumbles. I don't know how to explain it. But I'm feeling the baby move. Baby's good. Next week, I'm gonna make my appointment for a sneak peek to find out what we are having, so that we can have our little gender reveal here at the house with our family. So yeah, it's been a good journey. I've been enjoying myself. I feel like more rested this time, which is why I wanted the type of job that I got. If you don't know, like, I'm no longer working outside of the home. I'm an analyst at home. So that's just what I needed, because I'm a crybaby now, y'all. Like, I just be whining and crying, and just, that's another thing. I be crying so much. Like, went to Half Show yesterday to get some dinner. The lady told me it was gonna be an hour wait. I just left. I was like, you know it ain't gonna be no hour wait. I just couldn't handle that she said it, and I went and got in the car and started crying. Like, just give me a moment. Just give me a moment. The drop of a hat, baby. I'm in tears. You hear me? Like, don't say nothing wrong. Don't say nothing sly. Like, I'm gonna start crying. And I don't remember being like that with the girls. Alex said he just remember me being in the bed a lot. Like, I don't know. But yeah, this one, I'm feeling all the emotions, honey. To the fullest. That's leading me to tears. To tears. Thank you. My sense. But yeah, it's been good so far. I'm gonna do a separate video with like products I've been using and different like things I've been taking as far as prenatals and stuff for people who would be interested. Yes.
Happy Mother's Day.
Aww, thank you. Aww. For me? Thank you. Y'all got my favorite candy?
Yeah.
How sweet. Thank you. Can I have a kiss? Thank you.
Daddy do this too.
Do he helped too?
Uh-huh.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Rose, you need to wash your face again.
Okay. Have mercy.
Thank you. Oh, look at the little heart. What can we wish you for Mother's Day? Happiness, lots of it. The heart of the family kind. The surrounded by love kind. The lasting forever kind. All that times two, because it's from the both of us to you. Ah, thanks, girls.
You're welcome.
So sweet. Thanks, babe. I know you picked it up. Did best mom ever.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I love the flowers. It's so pretty. I'm gonna put it in my corner. Cause it's mine. I hope they stay up like the Valentine's balloons. Thank y'all. So sweet.
Don't forget you picked up that moss or something.
Okay. Thank you. It's a good day.
Great day.
Blessed day. Where's my face? I don't know if I'm gonna edit that out, but that was like a natural moment. So I got my Mother's Day things. Anywho. Okay, and the last thing, since we are wrapping this up. Do y'all want to see my outfit and like what I'm wearing? Like my final, is this a get ready with me? It feels like a get ready with me. But the last thing I want to talk about is the passing of controversial love expert or relationship expert guru, Kevin Samuels. I want to say this to the ladies. Coming from a place of Galatians 6:7 to be exact, which is, do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. A man reaps what he sows. Coming from a place of that, there's no need to celebrate. There's no need to be outlandish about it. Like, I'm not telling you how to. Yeah, I am. We shouldn't be doing that. We should not be doing that. We should not be celebrating anybody's death. Because at the end of the day, a man reaps what he sows. And you also reap what you sow. And you don't want to be out here celebrating a man's death, no matter what he said, no matter what he did. We know he said some horrible things about domestic abuse. We know he said some horrible things about not believing your children when they're sexually abused. We know all of that. And with us knowing all of that, for him to die at the tender age of 56 or 57 years old, the law of Galatians is present. You see what I'm saying? So there's no need to comment on it. Like, no comment. It's comment enough, in my opinion. So I just feel like we should just leave it at that. We should just leave it at that, and that we shouldn't stoop to a certain level to celebrate. Does that make sense? Because then it just kind of looks like you're on the same level as that. And it's just not good. So that's all I want to say about that. Let's just be careful what kind of energy we put out there, right? What we're welcoming. Because, you know, it's just nothing's promised. Sin is out here. And we need to focus on other things, like spiritually protecting our families, spiritually protecting ourselves, spiritually protecting our homes. We got work to do, and it don't involve celebrating no man's death, okay? So that's what I'm signing off with. Let's sign off with, make your life beautiful, make your life the way you want it, take care of yourself, take care of your spirituality, take care of your emotions, take care of yourself physically, make your life beautiful. Buy yourself flowers, buy what you want to make your home feel like a home. You know what I'm saying? Like, really rest in that divine femininity that you can create the life that you want for yourself, and you can create and influence the vibe of your family around you. We have a very important job. And protect your home, protect your loved ones, and like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm gonna show y'all what I'm wearing. So I'm gonna sign off with like, comment, and subscribe in just a second. This is the dress. Me and Baby Petty are in, large and in charge, as you can see. Y'all, my navel is like inside out. It's like I'm carrying high. And then I just have all this blubber on the bottom. So my body is wrecked. But anyways. But yeah, this is our little dress. The girls have matching dresses. Do y'all want to see them? Yeah, we have matching dresses.
Oh yeah, scooch over. We have matching dresses.
Yeah, fix.
We're taking jacket off.
I mean, you don't have to, but I'm just saying fix the sweater. But yeah, so our dresses match. We actually wore these on Easter 2021, I think. And I just thought we'd get one more wear out of them before the girls can't fit theirs anymore. If I have a girl, then I'm keeping one of these dresses for the new baby. But if it's a boy, then no. But yeah, so we have those. So the last thing I'm gonna take y'all on a journey for is to pick out the fragrance that I'm gonna wear. I really wanna try this Michael Kors that I got. And I really just wanna wear this because it's so springy. I think I wanna layer these. Let's see how that goes. So I couldn't really show y'all, but what I did is I just used the cotton round and I put the scent on there, both scents, and then I just kind of like dabbed it at my different pressure points, cleavage, my wrist, you know, so because I didn't want it to be, they're both floral and they're both kind of bold, so I just didn't want it to be like too much. And like, I can get tired of myself being pregnant with my pregnant nose. I'm very sensitive, so yeah, I didn't want to like make myself sick. But I do think I'm gonna go ahead and spritz some Thank You Next on my actual dress, because that's a scent I know that I like to smell. But it's, you only need two spritz because it's really strong. So yeah, so thank you guys for watching. I hope it's not too long, but if so, then thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Happy Mother's Day to all the mommies, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.